It was when I came into the African National Congress that I realized that causes are only a part of the African people. That the task of the ANC was to unite the African people and out of them build a nation.
We're just gathered here today for a short ceremony and the laying of a couple of wreaths to remember our great friend and comrade Nelson Madiba Mandela. Madiba was a great friend of Ireland, and he was also a great friend of the Republican movement. But he was, in his own right, a remarkable individual and a great leader. And the theme of the reports about his death have focused on the great sense of reconciliation that he showed after so much suffering at the hands of the apartheid South African regime. And Mandela was consistent in his principles. He never forgot the people who helped him and helped the South African struggle in their time of need. And that was why, during our transition, that he was happy to get involved himself, and he was happy to send his most senior people over here to help us in our transition from armed struggle into the peace process. But he's also a man of great humour and devilment. When I had the privilege of meeting Mandela in 2001, we went, a small delegation, myself, Jerry, Richard McCauley, my late wife Siobhan O'Hanlon, who organised the whole trip, and my 2.5-year-old son Cormac. When we went to Mandela's house in Johannesburg, when Jerry went into the room to meet Mandela, he was on the phone, and he said to whoever he was speaking to, "I'm sorry, I must go. The King of Ireland has just arrived." And that was the sense of humour and devilment that Mandela had. And my young son Cormac presented him with a toy truck filled with sweets. Cormac had said that's what he wanted to give Mandela, and he gave him the sweets and he gave him a kiss, but he wouldn't talk to him. And Mandela said to him, "You would have done well in the old apartheid regime. You refused to talk." So he had that sense of humour. He had a lack of bitterness. He wasn't a pacifist. He still justified the South African armed struggle, and he understood where we were coming from. I listened to a poem from a South African woman on the radio today, and the last lines of it were, and I think they're a great legacy for the South African people and for us here in Ireland. "Never ever again will we be prisoners in our own land."
And united we shall stand. Let us live and strive for freedom in South Africa. Alleluia.
I have fought against white domination, and I have fought against black domination. I have cherished the ideal of a democratic and free society in which all persons live together in harmony and with equal opportunity. It is an ideal which I hope to live for and to achieve. But if need be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.